our today's lesson topic is how you pass some of our game.
First of all,
before we link our today's lesson topic is, let us see what is the IUPAC. What's IUPAC? What is IUPAC? Yes. What is the IUPAC means?
IUPAC means
an abbreviation stands for International Union for Applied Chemistry. IUPAC means is an abbreviation. An abbreviation stands for International Union for Applied Chemistry. IUPAC is an abbreviation stands for International Union for Applied Chemistry.
IUPAC system is
a system of naming corresponding alkene and the most organic compounds. We can use the IUPAC system name any compound. Those are a more branched chain hydrocarbon. A IUPAC system is have this own rule. IUPAC system has its own rule. Let us see one by one. Rule number one is, before naming the one compound, rule number one is, first, identify the longest continuous chain. Identify the longest continuous chain. The second rule is, count from ending error to the side chain. The third rule is, if the same substituent appears on the longest continuous chain, use the prefix like di. If twice, three times, four times, five times, six times, use the prefix like di, tri, tetra, penta, hexa, hepta. If the same substituent appears two times, three times, four times, five times, six times, uses a prefix like di, tri, tetra, penta, hexa, respectively. We have two common substance in this all rule. The one is number and the other is substituent. If Number and the number comes together, you can separate by commas. If number and the letter comes together, you can separate by hyphen or dash line. Rule number 4. Number and number separated by commas. Commas. Rule number 5. Letter and number are separated by hyphen. Letter and the number. Separated by hyphen. Or dash line. Rule number six. Arrange the alphabetical order. Arrange alphabetical order. To apply this rule, let us see the typical example of hydrocarbon. Let us see the typical example. For example, let us take CH3, CH2, CH3. Let us see the typical example of this. What is the UPAC name? Give the UPAC name of the following compound. Give the UPAC name of the following compounds. Give the UPAC name of the following compounds. Let us see the typical example of this compound. First of all, before we really begin, I think we can identify the longest continuous chain. We have different possibilities on this compound. Let us find the longest continuous chain. Where is the longest continuous chain? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The longest continuous chain is a straight chain. The longest continuous chain is a straight chain. The longest continuous chain is a straight chain. This is the longest continuous chain. This is the longest continuous chain. This is longest continuous chain. Longest continuous chain. This is the longest continuous chain. We can get the longest continuous chain. Then we apply the rule number 2. Rule number 2 says count from end mirror to the third chain. Where we can go? From left to right or left to right? From the left to right or right to left? When we go here, from left to right, 1, 2, 3. From carbon number 3, we have a substituent. When we go from the right to left, 1, 2, 3. Both sides the same. Whether you can go from it, whether you can come from there, it is nothing. Both directions it is possible. Because when we go from it, we can get the substituent. carbon number 1, 2, 3.
Where we come from here?
We can get the solution on the carbon number 3. Due to this, it is possible to go in all direction. So, if we go from here, carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3, carbon number 4, carbon number 5, carbon number 6, carbon number 7, carbon number 8, carbon number 9.
So, the longest continuous chain is, the longest continuous chain is Nonne.
The longest continuous chain is, as a parent name, it is on Nonne. Nonne.
So, we have two types of substituent or side chain.
This, we have a methyl. This, we have a ethyl. Here we have a methyl.
So, as rule number 3, if the same substituent is appears 2 times, 3 times, 4 times, 5 times, 6 times, using the prefix like dihedra, tetra, penta, and hexa respectively. So, we have 1 methyl, 2 methyl, 3 methyl. If the substituent is 3 methyl, we use the trimethyl. We have a 1 ethyl. Then we can name this compound just like that. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 ethyl. 4 ethyl. Number and the letter are separated by this hyphen. 4 ethyl. 4 ethyl hyphen. 4 ethyl hyphen. 1, 2, 3. Carbon number 3. 4, 5, 6, 7. So, carbon number 1, 2, 3, 7, hyphen, trimethyl, nonne. This is the name of this compound. For ethyl, at the carbon number 4, there is a ethyl. At carbon number 3 and also at carbon number 7, there is a dimethyl. Means this is methyl, this is methyl at carbon number 7. So 3, 7, hyphen trimethyl.